Carl and I really came to the conclusion that the only fair thing to do to the audience was to make something that felt like a big epic ending that would give our real loyal fans some kind of closure on the show.
I was interested in how they were going to do it. There's so many pieces of the puzzle to wrap up.
We really wanted the Colorado itself, Marcus, Sam, all the major characters to have some kind of great conclusion.
The way it all goes down is kind of fitting, but still no less emotional and epic.
If the 13th episode was going to be the last of Last Resort, then it had to end this way.
It's been an honor, sir.
I think the legacy of Marcus Chaplin will be honor and resistance, which is a slogan that was part of our show and really important to us.
Marcus going down is a big, bold move, and it makes sense, and it's sacrifice.
It felt true to me as a character that if there was any chance that that submarine might fall into bad hands, that he wasn't going to allow it to happen, that he was the captain who was willing to go down with the ship. I think part of him doesn't necessarily want to go back to that country and is at peace with himself.
I want revenge. I don't need Krishna, I don't need Buddha, I don't even Jesus to show me my path. Mine is clear. I find the ones that made this happen. I balance the scales.
Sam finds the thing that Marcus already had, which is purpose, what's worth fighting for. I don't know that Sam knows that entirely at the beginning of the series, but I think by the end, he knows what he would lay his life down for and what he wouldn't.
In those last couple moments of the finale, Sam and Christine coming together is very much a moment of, we've been through all this, I know who you are, you know who I am, and we're gonna go, we're gonna do this.
You know, I get the sense that Sam's not just going back to Navy duty anytime right away.
He's someone that's gonna have to sit in front of these hearings and answer questions, but eventually that's gonna go away. Whatever fault is found will probably be put at the feet of Marcus Chaplin.
I really like the way that they finished Kylie's storyline.
Mr. President?
She does come out a hero, and she completes her arc of learning to do the right thing, which is weird to say about shooting somebody.
I don't think Kylie goes free in some way. I don't think you can do that, even if most people might agree with the result. One thing I can tell you is I'm sure she's got the best lawyers fighting for her.
I leave it up to the viewers to understand exactly what happened to Kylie after she pulled that trigger. I sort of think she went down in a hail of bullets, but I'll leave it there.
What happened?
Do you still think you owe me something, James?
Yeah, I do.
He was always gonna go with Grace and stay on the sub, or with Tani and stay on the island. And he chose Tani.
It is a very natural place for them to be because they are drawn to each other and they do want each other very much.
He sort of figured out who he was by the end. He made that decision to leave that life of violence and move on to something else. So he sort of, it's like a coming of age for him.
I don't want you to be a killer anymore. Not for me. Not for anyone.
I really think that he's found his happy place, you know?
It worked.
I think the thing I'm most proud of this season is that you've never seen a TV show like this ever.
It was a huge story.
It's a pretty big, epic adventure story, and to pull it off, I think, is amazing in itself.
There's nothing to compare this to. I literally cannot think of another show that was like this.
The story that we were able to tell was really strong.
The 13 episodes as a story arc are tremendously fulfilling and very satisfying.
I think it questioned a lot of our ideals.
There's a lot packed into 13 episodes.
I think we made a really great show. I'm really proud of it.